I want you to take a moment and envision yourself getting into the squatting position or the kneeling position or going down a flight of stairs. When you envision yourself doing these things, do you immediately associate these activities or these positions with knee pain? Well, you wouldn't be alone. It's probably one of the most common complaints when I'm working on these exact skills. So, because I think a lot of those activities that I mentioned are super important to just getting through your day, as well as being able to do a lot of the activities that I talk about on this channel, which are in kneeling and half kneeling, I thought I would do a little mini series dedicated to the knee, specifically knee pain, some of the things that could be causing your knee pain, some of the things that you might have been told are causing your knee pain, but not might actually be the cause of your knee pain, as well as solutions to help you move and get through your day with less knee pain. If you're new to this channel, I'm Tara. I'm a neurologic physical therapist. And on this channel, we talk about anything and everything related to mobility, health, fitness, wellness, mindset, in the context of those of you who've had damage to your brain or your spinal cord, with the end goal of giving you more hope and more confidence in your own abilities to take ownership of your rehab. And all that being said, as the title suggests, we are going to start this series talking about anything and everything having to do with arthritic knees. It's probably the number one kind of diagnosis that patients tell me they have, either because they Googled it or because they've been to an orthopedic surgeon and been diagnosed with it, as far as what they believe is the cause of their knee pain. So let's go ahead and break down the knee joint first, or do a deeper dive explanation of the knee joint in general. Then we're going to get into some of the things that cause pain in the knee related to arthritis. And then at the very end, we're going to get into some of the solutions. So first, big picture. What does the knee joint look like? So the knee joint is made up of bones. That's the femur, the tibia, and the patella, or the kneecap. It includes cartilage. And cartilage just caps the ends of the bones and serves as a protective barrier to allow the bones to just glide on each other when you're bending and extending, in this case, the knee. Ligaments, which kind of hold the knee joint together. A meniscus, which is a padding that sits between the femur and the tibia and kind of serves as a shock absorber. The knee joint also includes muscles. And important for this video, especially this talk on arthritis, is a synovial membrane. The knee joint is a synovial joint, and that means that it does have a membrane around it that secretes synovial fluid, which helps to lubricate the joint, kind of like WD-40 for your knees. And one potential cause of pain in the knee joint is, as the title suggests, osteoarthritis. And osteoarthritis is when those end caps that I mentioned earlier, that cartilage starts to wear down. Now, what are some other symptoms associated with knee arthritis? You could have stiffness. You could start losing range of motion in your knee. You could see some swelling, or your knee might be warm to the touch. And you might hear strange noises. We call that crepitus. Now let's talk about what causes knee arthritis. Big picture, some of the risk factors that might predispose someone to having arthritis in their knees is a previous injury, people that are older, so it is just kind of an age-related change, that degeneration of that cartilage. When we're younger, we actually build that cartilage up as we load the joints, and then we hit a certain age where it actually starts to wear down the more we load that joint. Obesity and genetics can also play a role, meaning if you have a family history of it, you might be more susceptible to developing arthritis in your knees. Now, it's important to keep in mind that just because your cartilage is wearing down doesn't necessarily mean you're going to have pain. I've had lots of patients over the years that I can actually hear that there's something grinding on something in their knee joints, and we'll get into what potentially those noises mean, but I hear lots of noises. Sometimes from across the room, I can hear someone's knees when they stand up from a chair, and they have zero pain. So please be aware that just because you've been diagnosed with arthritis in your knees doesn't necessarily mean it is the cause of your pain. That's why this series is going to be so critical. You may have more control over your pain than you actually think you have at this moment. So let's exclude the people that aren't having pain, because obviously you probably wouldn't be watching this video if you didn't have pain associated with your arthritis. But what is actually causing the pain in your knee joints? It's not necessarily the breakdown of the cartilage, because that cartilage is what we call avascular. I mean, it doesn't have a blood supply. It really doesn't have sensation. But when you start to have that area or that cartilage wear down, it kind of initiates an immune response because your body is very, very good at protecting things from damaging it, whether that be chemicals, infections, things like that. That's why we have an immune system. And you actually do get kind of an immune response when that cartilage starts to wear down because your knees kind of throw up this warning sign that something's wrong. And that in and of itself, that inflammation can actually be what causes the pain. So every time you stand up and you move around, you get this trauma to your knee. This inflammatory process keeps repeating itself. It's sending these inflammatory kind of mediators to the area. They kind of sit there and they're not good. They kind of start breaking down other structures in the knee, and that's actually what starts to cause the pain. The other thing you might develop because of this immune response is you get kind of little bone formation in the knee joint, and that can also be potentially be a cause of the pain. Now, why do I bring this up? Because I have this theory that I think is going to be good to share because I think it'll give you a little bit of ownership. I almost think that we do have control over inflammation in our system in general. And the reason I say that is kind of a personal story, but I've probably spent more than half my life around endurance athletes, people that run hundreds of miles. And you think about the trauma on their knee joints. And probably in the last 20 years, I know maybe two or three people that have actually had knee pain or had a knee replacement. And I have been around people that are in their 60s and 70s and have been running their entire life and have zero knee pain. And so I kind of feel like, yes, genetics maybe does play a little bit of a role. Yes, they're not obese because they're, you know, they've spent their entire life running. So that's not, they don't have that risk factor. But I'm always fascinated by the fact that they have put probably the most wear and tear on their knee joints. And literally, I know very few people that have actually had a knee replacement as a result of running hundreds of miles a week for years and years and years. And I kind of think that this inflammatory process that goes on might be more of a contributing factor, not inflammation as a result of abnormal stresses on the knee, because that is one potential cause, is that structurally you'll hear a lot of other kind of orthopedic therapists talk about this, but you're flat-footed or your knees cave in, you have abnormal stresses on the knee, and so that causes the cartilage or that protective mechanism to wear down a little bit faster. But I also think that maybe just chronic inflammation caused by poor diet, not drinking enough water, things like that might also predispose someone to having painful knee arthritis. Because again, I think we're all going to eventually hit a point where our cartilage starts to wear down, but this inflammatory process. So now why do I tell you this? Because I think that it is never too late to look at your diet a little bit and see if there are ways that you can decrease the amount of inflammation. So I'm not going to get into that in depth because that's not the point of this video, but in general, generally speaking, this is my rule of thumb. The more processes something has to go through to get into your body, the more kind of processes it has to go through once it's in your body, like the cells have to work on those items that you put in your mouth and that go into your stomach to kind of undo that and get it down into something that your body can utilize for fuel. And I think that creates inflammation. So eating things that are in their most natural state, I think, is the kind of big picture principle that can help to decrease inflammation. Now, you'll find lots of people out there. I talk about the Walls protocol and her book quite a bit. I'll put a link for her book in the description below because I think it's excellent at talking about diet and how it relates to what food does to our neurologic system. So definitely, I will link that video below. But I think it's never too late to look at diet as far as a potential cause that's creating this chronic inflammation that could be causing some of your knee pain. Now, another personal story is that I experience pain and I always can trace it back to not drinking enough water during the day. I start upping my water. And a lot of those aches and pains that I feel first thing in the morning or at the end of a long day are definitely less. So two things, drinking more water and something that is totally in your control, not that it's easy, but it is in your control, is what you're actually putting into your body. Now, for those of you that have been diagnosed with severe osteoarthritis in your knees and you feel like every day is painful, do not despair. There is hope. So now let's get into some of the treatments. Any of you that are experiencing pain in your knees should leave this video feeling hopeful that you have more control than you think you do over your knee pain. So I went to the CDC to look at what their treatment list, their list of treatments was for knee arthritis or osteoarthritis in the knees. And surgery is not the only option. In fact, it's only one of a long list of options. So what does the CDC recommend? CDC says to increase your activity level, get into physical therapy, muscle strengthening, yes, weight loss. There are some medications and pain relievers. Talk to your doctor about this one, but yes, there are medications to decrease your pain. Pull that device out of the closet, pull that cane out, pull that walker out. Why do I say that? Because of the first one, physical activity. Lack of movement, in my opinion, is why just normal wear and tear, breakdown, wearing down of that cartilage, why it turns into pain is because you are not moving. So that lubricant, that synovial fluid, if you're not bending and extending those knees, you're not walking on those legs, you're not bearing weight, loading those legs, well, your body's just not going to be as efficient at producing that synovial fluid. Remember that synovial fluid? That's the WD-40 into your knee joints. If you're not moving, your body just probably doesn't feel the need to lubricate your joints. Therefore, that system becomes less efficient. So pull that device out if you need to. Do whatever you can to increase your activity. And then of course the CDC does also recommend surgery, but I want to make it very clear that that's one of a long list of treatments. As I've said and say in lots of videos, there is no magic pill to anything really, to any health condition really. Everything takes work and surgery is painful. Trust me, I still work one day a week in the hospital. In most of the time, I'm on an orthopedic floor where I just see people late at night after they get out of surgery. Most of the patients I see for that few hours, you know, once a week or once every other week, have just had a total knee replacement or a total hip replacement. And let me tell you, it hurts. Surgery hurts. And guess what? After surgery, what makes that surgery successful? Movement. What makes that surgery not successful? Not moving. So it is still going to circle back to movement. Now, I know that most of you that watch this channel have had damage to your brain or your spinal cord. You might be in a wheelchair. You can't move like you did before. Totally understandable, but there's still things that you can do. You can stand, you can move your legs sitting in your chair. You can do strengthening exercises. You can do exercises in bed. Really do a deep dive inventory, a little self-reflection here, and see if you really are doing everything that you can be doing to make sure that you're getting lots of movement in. Now, again, initially, it's going to hurt because it's new. You're going to be moving your knees if you kind of listen to some of these suggestions or recommendations, which I understand not everyone's going to be on board with this and they're just going to want to have surgery. But if you are on board with this, it's going to hurt. It's your body's not used to it. But I promise you, if you push through it, there is a high likelihood that you will decrease your knee pain. So now, the CDC treatment options were a little bit limited. So I went one step further and I went to the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons to see what they had to say as far as treatments for knee arthritis. And they have a pretty in-depth list of recommendations based on the current evidence. In all of the recommendations, there were a board of, I believe it was therapists as well as orthopedic surgeons, and a couple of other healthcare professionals that looked at the evidence and based on the evidence rated the strength of the recommendation. And the things that got the highest rating as far as treatment for painful arthritis in the knees is exercise. That could include land-based exercise or aquatics, which I think is a great alternative because it does take some of the load off of your joints. Neuromuscular training, weight loss got a pretty high rating as far as an intervention. Now, very interesting, I wanted to include a few more. Now, I'll put a link for this clinical practice guideline in the description to this video. So I'm just highlighting a few, but one observation I made is there's another group of recommendations that had somewhat of a lower recommendation or a lower strength rating, and that was massage, laser treatment, TENS, which is eSTEM, and platelet-rich plasma. Now, why I pulled those ones out are those are all passive treatments. And I think the reality is that you do have the control. You definitely have power in your wheelhouse right now to decrease the amount of pain you're having in association with your knee pain, but it's going to take work. I just think that there's no quick fix. There's no easy solution to this. And one thing I want to make really clear is you can develop a fear of movement if you've had arthritis for a really long time. And so what I mean by that is now when you move, this fear response kicks in because in the past your pain's just kind of gotten worse and worse and worse. But maybe it's just because you just haven't done it in a progressive manner, or you haven't chosen an exercise or activity that wasn't painful. So maybe you could do bed level exercises. Maybe you can do strengthening exercises sitting in your chair. Those are definitely great options. But I think the most important thing is that you just get in the habit of moving. Now, for those of you who know that you have knee arthritis and you've already decided that you're not going to have surgery, or doctors told you you're not a candidate for surgery, yes, there's one way of looking at that and just being completely hopeless, lost cause, you're going to be in pain forever. But also, maybe you can watch this video through a couple of times and really do a deep dive inventory or self-reflection to see, have you really done everything on this list that is in your control and is in your power right now to address your arthritis that are given very strong recommendations based on the current evidence that they work, that they help to decrease pain. So definitely being honest with yourself to say, really, have you done everything, or did you just jump to surgery because it seemed like the quickest fix? Which I know we're all very instant gratification minded in this technological era, but maybe the shortest distance to your destination is not always the best method. So maybe looking at some of these things that might take a little bit more work, a little bit more effort, might take a little bit longer time frame to get rid of that pain. Maybe there are things that are more in your control that you can definitely do. Now, the other thing I want to bring up is that maybe it has nothing to do with your arthritis, which I think is way more common with the patients that I see who maybe have been diagnosed or the Google told you you had arthritis in your knee. I have a suspicion that there's a lot of people that think they might have arthritis in their knee that's really not due to arthritic changes, or your pain is not due to arthritic changes in your knee, but they could be a result of the damage to your nervous system, such as your brain's perception of pain, such as spasticity, such as abnormal movement patterns, or just lack of movement in general, being in a bed for a prolonged period of time. I think there's a lot of you that might think you have arthritis in your knees that might fall into one of these other categories. And so I think it is 1000% beneficial for you to come back to next week's video, because in next week's video, I'm gonna address all of those possible factors of things that are contributing to your knee pain, as well as solutions or things that you can do to help kind of move that needle a little bit, getting you out of pain slowly, and starting to incorporate some of these activities back into your life, some of the positions that I think are super duper important to start doing, get you walking without feeling like you're gonna hurt all the time, maybe even possibly going up and down stairs without pain. All of that is stuff that I'm gonna go over in next week's video. If you're new to this channel and you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on that notification bell so that you will get notified every time I upload new videos. I enjoyed spending time with you all today, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.